Hey everyone, Garmadillion Carmelius here, and today I'm going to be going over some predictions for Arcade of ReZero, which has just started and is currently on its third chapter. So if you haven't read up to there yet, just don't watch, or if it's way ahead, then you can look back here, see my predictions. So in this video, I just want to go over something that's pretty essential to this arc, the existence of zombies. And so first I'll just go over the ones we already know, and then go into some more possibilities of what we could get. So yeah, I'm just going to be doing zombie predictions this arc. So the first zombie we see is the goat himself, Balroy Temeglyph, and he reincarnated together with Carrion, which is his beloved dragon. And this is probably because flying dragon riders actually, they share their odd with their dragons. So when Balroy was reincarnated, it probably just caused Carrion to get reincarnated alongside with him, because their odds are connected. So anyway, he's fighting Moguro in the city alongside Midzoria, who's possessed by Madeline Eshard. So I think what will likely happen to them is that Midzoria and Balroy will defeat Moguro, and then Balroy, who's still under the control of Sphinx, because she's controlling all the zombies, he's going to start attacking Midzoria and refusing to reason. And Madeline's conscious, which is in Midzoria, will like start to get flustered by that. And yeah, she'll return to her real body, which is currently with Amelia. I think she'll eventually come into contact with Julius, and I think later she's gonna try and rush off and go to see Balroy with her true body, and Julius is gonna end up going after her and try to protect her, since Julius has actually read Balroy's Book of the Dead in Arc 6, and he would probably feel a responsibility to ensure Madeline remains alive for his atonement due to killing Balroy. I think this plot line will probably end with Madeline accepting Balroy's death after the zombie version dies, and she's gonna move on from her rage. I guess that she'd go live with Flop and Medium after all is said and done. I'd say this is what I'm most excited for in Arc 8. I'm really hyped for this, so I can't wait to see what Hape does. So the next major zombie we see is Lamia, and she's along with 20 other gang sword users, and we find out that these are actually all from the Imperial Selection Ceremony that Abel Vincent participated in. So they all spawned in the throne room, so I think it's possible that they're going to serve as some sort of governing body for the zombies, and they're going to be the ones directing like all the strategies and stuff. Lamia could also give some character exploration for Burstetts, and also Vincent. I'm not exactly too sure how this one's going to play out, like I am with the Balroy stuff, but I think they're going to prove a pretty major obstacle in the arc. On the cover for Volume 33, there's also the bald zombie, and even though currently in the text we're still unaware who he is, it seems likely that he used to be a gladiator on Ginnonhive, as his clothing and overall appearance seems to match that with what we've seen from characters like Neji Rockhard and the Pleiades Battalion from the Volume 33 illustrations. In EX5, we do know that Al killed several bald gladiators, but this guy could really just be anyone from there, maybe even the Gladiator King, but like without the helmet. And that would actually be pretty interesting, because Al's helmet is a replica of the Gladiator King's, so I'm pretty sure the bald guy is going to show up wherever Al is. Most of the other zombies we see in both cover and text so far are mainly default Imperial soldiers, so kind of like NPCs, but there's nothing really noteworthy about them. At the end of Chapter 3, though, we do get someone that we do know, and Todd notes that it's the zombie of the Cyclops tribe, and he notes that it's like the guy who was standing out earlier on the battlefield, so that clearly implies that the zombie is male from Chapter 86 of Arc 7, and we see him die to Todd in the web novel, but in the light novel, it's only Rocky that kills him. But yeah, either way, Ismail is back. I think it'll be an interesting encounter for Todd and like Subrum Gang to get past, but I'm not really sure it's going to be too important. Seems like it'll just be like a little mini boss for early Arc 8. Okay, so that's everything we know so far, but here's where stuff starts to get a little more interesting, because there are a ton of possibilities for the zombies that could get brought back in this arc. So, right off the bat, I want to start off with Kirita's soul sister, Mariuli, and I think she's going to be revived. So, it's already been established as a plot point in Arc 7, and I think it's going to carry over to Arc 8 to sort of complete Kirita's character arc. You can also sort of support this claim by the fact that Kirita's chapter parallels Flop's, In those chapters, Balroy's role of the beloved sibling who passed away is kind of similar to Mariuli. So since Balroy came back, I think it's fair to say Mariuli might also come back. This could also have implications for Utakata, but yeah, moving on. I think several figures from EX5 are also possible for revival, namely Gaito, Hornet, and Auron. All seem like good candidates. Hornet was the strongest one on the island when Al was there, and she was known as the Gladiator Empress. It was said like she could rival some of the Nine Divine Generals. So I think she's gonna, if she does come back, it would make sense because she's so strong, and I think she would be a pretty formidable enemy. As for Gaito, he isn't really too special, but he did have some contacts with Al, so it could be possible. And finally, Auron was Al's best friend on the island, and his only friend on the island. So I think it would be interesting for Al's character if we saw a zombie version of Auron. As for some of the other characters in EX5, it seems like all the Yang Sword siblings were also brought back, along with Lamia. But I think it's also possible that we see some stronger soldiers come back, like the ones who were in Lamia's Pruning Corps. There's also some characters like Jorah who died in EX5, but I'm not really too sure if he's going to come back. If he does, there is some potential for some character moments regarding Serena and Priscilla, since they were both pretty involved with him. Another character who could come back is Gowron Payshit, who died when he was trying to kill Vincent in the capital around the time of EX5. Specifically when all the rebellions were happening around the Empire. So the Imperial capital was weakened because there were no Divine Generals there. But he ended up dying by the hand of Rowan, who we do know will be playing a role in Arc 8. So I think if Gowron comes back, that'd be pretty cool. He's also a Flying Dragon Rider, so if he comes back, it'll probably be similar to Balroy in that he'll be with his Flying Dragon. And Gowron's Flying Dragon's actually pretty cool. It's a white dragon that's known for its beauty named Faeron, and I think Gowron wields a halberd, so I think if we get him, it would be pretty cool. There's also a possibility for Jamal and Katya's dead family members to return, since the Aureli family lore is that Jamal fucking killed all of his family because he didn't like them being mean to Katya. So he did it lawfully by like duels and stuff, but Jamal literally murked everyone. So this next one, I think is actually pretty likely. So in chapter 98 of Arc 7, Tape mentioned a character by the name of Viva the Dissector. And so basically at that time when the Emperor Mercio of Wallachia tried to bring his Yang magic boosted army into battle, he was completely defeated due to how fucking shit his army was. But Viva came in, the absolute bro ally of the Emperor. He slapped around the enemy leader, go, bop, 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 bop. Fucking dead. Viva's just too cool for you guys. But anyway, I think it may seem like an offhand mention that chapter, but Tape does like to plant some seeds when he plans on doing things later. So an example of this is like in chapter 60 of Arc 7, he mentioned Iris in the King of Thorns, and then in chapter 80, we got the chapter Iris and the King of Thorns. And then also in chapter 80, he mentioned the Sacrament of the Immortal King, and now at the start of Arc 8, we find out that Sphinx is using the Sacrament of the Immortal King to bring back all the dead people. So it is a pattern for Tape to sort of mention these things and then bring them up a bit later. So especially since he mentioned Viva in chapter 98, I think it's likely we see him come back. And on the note of Iris and the King of Thorns, I think it might make sense for the man himself to come back as a zombie. Because right now we still have Yorna's Iris plotline ongoing, and who knows, she may or may not end up dying this arc, at the very least having her curse removed, but I think it would make sense for the King of Thorns to come back and have some sort of character moment with Yorna. All from Yorna, obviously Tanza. I think we do know she has a dead sister, so I don't think it's too likely that the dead sister comes back. But who knows, anything could happen in this arc. It would be interesting, but I'm not really that keen on it happening. It might, who knows. There's also the potential for a dead sibling of Cecilus, since we know in the Ganon Hive chapters, Cecilus said that it's impossible for him to have an older or younger sibling, because his dad would have killed his older sibling the moment he had Cecilus, and if his dad had another kid, then he would have killed Cecilus. So, it sort of makes it seem like if Cecilus is right about that, then maybe Rowan or like, had another kid or something and then killed it because it was too fucking weak. And he wanted a strong kid. He's Wallachian. He wanted to raise a strong boy. But anyway, there's also some possibility for characters that we don't actually know to come back. You know, it's not like we know the entire history of Wallachia in the story. So I expect we might be seeing some new guys that are just, like, legends of Wallachia's past to get revived. So some of the stuff I want to kind of see is maybe an adult dragonkin that's brought back, like one in their prime. I feel like that would be much stronger than Madeline is currently, and it would be pretty cool as well. Maybe tie it in with Gauz, because it's implied that Gauz was, he was involved in the genocide of the dragonkin. So I think that could be quite cool. But yeah. We also have a chance for Cheesha to come back, and that's really interesting, because Cheesha's death was sort of the trigger, not really trigger, because Balrog came back first, but it was a sign that the great disaster was starting, is what the commandment said to, like, Ubilk. But yeah, if Cheesha does come back, it would sort of add a deeper meaning to the arc title, Vincent Wallachia, and it could add a lot of really good exploration for Vincent and Cheesha's characters. And it would also be, like, really tragic, because, man, imagine bringing Cheesha back after 107. Like, that's brutal. So the last thing I want to talk about in this section is the possibility for those who died outside of Wallachia to get revived. From what I've seen, it seems like a lot of people think that you need to have died within Wallachia to get revived, but I sort of disagree. I think the only requirement is to have contact with the Great Spirit Mespil, and in order to meet this requirement, you need to have touched grass in the Empire. So the reason is simple. I think Sphinx is using Mespil as the medium for the sacrament spell. And the reason that the personalities are now intact is because Subaru unlocked the Taigeta library in Arc 6. The requirement to read the books of the dead is that one must have known the person, the dead person. So if you apply that to Mespil, then anyone who interacted with the Earth of Wallachia should be accessible. In Arc 6, we saw how Reed was reconstructed in the Watchtower, and it seems similar to the current reconstruction. Since Reed had his personality intact, his power intact, like, everything was just going smooth for him. And it's kind of similar here, except they're kind of more influenced by Sphinx, but I think that's a given because of Sacrament. But they have their personalities. We've seen both Balroy and Lamia demonstrate a sense of personality. And they, Balroy especially, we can see he has full abilities that he did when he was living. So yeah, I think it's similar. They're using the Books of the Dead to reconstruct them. But the difference with Reed is that they seem to be made of earth magic. And this is kind of evidenced through how they have pottery-like features and glowing yellow eyes, because yellow is the color of the earth element, and their bodies do seem to be made of some sort of earth-like material. So I think Sphinx is actually using Mespil's vast pools of mana to construct them, and using his access to the Taigeta library. So yeah, if this ends up being true, then it means we could also get some characters like Miles or some guys from the Stride camp. Miles would probably be paired up with Serena, Flop, and Medium, and that could be brilliant for character moments. I think Stride Camp also has tons of potential. Like, Stride could have great interactions with Vincent or Roswell, and Kurgan could also return for something impactful with, like, Gustav or Garfield. The Twin Shura could go back for, like, Olbart and maybe Roswell as well, because Roz J fucking died. Battle spoilers. Oh, hoo, hoo. And Melinda could also be brought back to sort of give us a further explanation of, like, the Evil Eye tribe and more of that lore. Maybe some history related to Ubilk as well. So yeah, I think that's the majority of my thoughts. This kind of wraps up everything I wanted to say for potential zombies that could be brought back. So yeah, let me know if you have any other ideas, or which ones of these you guys think are, like, the coolest, or which ones you're most hyped for or want to see the most. I think Stride would be really cool. I also want to see Miles, because I'm a simp for Balroy stuff. But yeah, that's pretty much most of it. I only really talked about the zombie stuff this video. Some of it might be wrong, but yeah, this is just a fun video to sort of discuss my thoughts. I might make some future videos about some more predictions for the arc, but for now, that's about it. Thanks for watching.